Good morning, Brain family. I hope y'all are all having an amazing day and that all is going well. How are y'all doing today? Comment down below. Let us know. We'll definitely respond back to you. Cora's actually taking a nap right now. We woke up a little bit early today because we had to take the girls to school. And it was, oh, she scared me.
Did I really? I'm sorry.
Eventually, this channel is going to be like a compilation of me
getting scared.
Yes.
I do it a lot.
Yes.
I just need to start recording like every moment that I scare you, because I can stand behind that and just be standing there against the wall. And then she'll go, oh, you scared me. And she'll walk past. So it's every moment.
If why I'm, are you mocking me?
I can be standing here doing something and she'll walk past and be like, oh, you scared me.
Why are you mocking me?
I'm not trying to. I'm just trying to tell them that you do it.
But I forgot what I was even saying now. Oh, my God.
That we woke up early to take the girls to school.
Yeah, okay. It was so weird because I was like, this is what it feels like to have teenagers. Like, they tell you there's busy schedules for the day, and one of them has to get picked up at 3:50, and the other one has to get up, like, picked up at, like, 4:20.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah, so Anne was supposed to be picked up at 3:30.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And now she needs to be picked up at 4, but we have to pick up Elise at 4:30.
But that's not it. We have to take her to, like, piano practice.
Wait, she has piano practice today? I thought that was tomorrow.
I don't know if it's today or tomorrow. I think it might be on Mondays. We're glad we don't have two teenagers.
Yeah, I'm glad we just have one Cora laying on a bed right now.
We're like, we're not ready for that level of responsibility yet. We cannot keep up with these extracurriculars. Once they grow up, they have like their own schedules.
Once they grew up?
They grow up. They just have...
I don't want Cora to grow up.
I don't want her to either. But she's going to start having her own schedule. She's going to have ballet practice. She's a little ballerina.
Yeah. Okay. I'm okay with that.
Oh, I cannot wait until they have recitals and they have like the daddy-daughter dances.
They saw that yesterday.
Yeah.
We did that at Target.
That is so true.
We're going to be the star of the show. How do you get a haircut? So where should we go first? What are we even doing? Are we just leaving?
Okay, first we're going to get a haircut because Cora's sleeping, so it's the best time to get a haircut. Second...
Wait, we're both getting haircuts?
No.
Oh, you don't want one?
Well, I want one, but it's going to take like hours and I need to find a good hairstylist.
Maybe you can find one in Orlando.
So every time we do my hair, we have to go to Orlando.
I'm okay with that.
I saw this thing on Amazon last night and it's kind of like a portable table for Cora.
Yeah.
And she can eat on it. She can play on it.
This
she can
so cool.
Put her tablet on it. It's going to keep her entertained for a long time, and it's going to be a lifesaver for us.
Yeah, it's the coolest thing ever. Like, here, is there space beside my head?
Yes, there's space beside.
There's the picture, right there. That's what it is. It looks really awesome, doesn't it?
Look at this view.
No, don't show them our butt. They don't get that. That's on the calendar.
Oh, look at that. Could you imagine sleeping in that position? My goodness.
It's so uncomfortable.
I know this looks weird, but this is how she literally sleeps every single night, in this position.
I think babies typically just sleep like this.
A lot of them like sleep like normal, but this one sleeps like this.
Is it defective?
I don't
think so. Oh my goodness, you have more eyebrows than your mama. I can see them, they're coming in. All right, let's go get me a haircut. I need it. Uh-oh. Let's go.
Hey, Daddy's getting a haircut.
Frankly, getting his haircut.
Do you want a haircut? Do you want to trim some of this off?
Sorry.
Thank you.
Thank you, Daddy.
No, it's good.
Thank you, have a good day.
Look, where's Daddy? Cora, look. Oh. Where are you pointing out? Daddy's right there. Look. Daddy.
Look at his hair.
his haircut. What is going on? You don't want them to see? Do you not like it?
No, I do. Mm-hmm. I just wanted to be dramatic
for a second. Let's do a 360.
Let's not.
There you go. Ooh, you look handsome.
Thank you.
So we were outside writing on the car, and Noah. Oh,
we should show him.
Sure.
We'll show you this one this time because we did it, I guess, the same as the last one.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. You're taller than I. We did it a little different than the last one.
I had a limited amount of space, so the word family is just.
It looks like it's all one word when you're like about 10 feet away.
It's tiny and smushed, but we're going to show you it. But I was saying Noah gave me a heart tattoo. And
yeah, and then I actually suggested a good idea.
Yeah, so, okay, wait, this is a.
Yeah.
This is the Brain family. This is pretty, and then there's like family.
Hey, that's my handwriting, and it looks better than normal.
Yeah.
I did good.
But I was like, I didn't think I was gonna get a tattoo today. Thank you for giving me a tattoo. And he was like, you should actually get a tattoo.
And what I said was, how about we give Anne and Elise the responsibility today to actually like pick your tattoo. I was like, so would you get a tattoo if Anne and Elise were to pick it and then you had to get it?
Okay, so the answer to that is no. But I was like, that sounds like such a great idea, but I'm actually not gonna get a tattoo. So this is what we're gonna do. I'm gonna be like, I think I wanna get a tattoo today. I think it would get a lot of views. It's great content. So I want y'all to pick my tattoos for me and draw it out. They're really gonna think that we're about to like all go to a tattoo parlor and I'm just gonna get
whatever. What if Elise or Anne make one that you actually like? Would you get it?
Probably not.
Jeez, then this is pointless. This is super pointless.
We got her fries from the McDonald's and she devoured it. She was like this. In the car. So we are going to clean up in the kitchen, a little bit all over the house, and then the kids have to get picked up at 4. Cora, you think you want to help mommy and daddy this time? By tearing off paper with your teeth? Yeah? Okay. All right, but we are going to do a little cleaning montage and get the house cleaned up a little bit.
So we had to end the cleaning montage super early, but that's okay because we need to go pick up Anne. We should have left already, but if we leave right now, we should be able to make it, right?
Yeah.
All right, so we'll catch back up with you guys when we pick up Anne.
So we just picked up Anne from school, and she got her phone taken up at school, and we cannot get it back because Noah and I are not listed guardians. And so we have to wait until her parents come home from vacation.
She was a bad person today. She decided she was gonna Google Translate her entire quiz in front of the teacher.
It was a question, and it was in the hallway too. I told my friends, I was like, cover me up, and I Google Translate it. And she's like, I need the two telephone por favor, and I was like, oh, okay.
They didn't have your back?
No.
They walked away, didn't they? They were like, no, she's right here using her phone.
Join us. You're a girl. Join us.
That was so fun.
Her head probably hurts so bad.
That was so fun. I enjoyed that. She's picking her nose. I don't think her head really hurts too bad. Oh my gosh.
She's like, this relieves it.
So as you just saw, we're home and we've been dancing. But I just thought we would hang out for a little bit before Elise and I. So pretty much, I'm gonna teach Elise how to fly a drone. And we're gonna start with mine since it's a little bit easier to fly. And as soon as we finish flying her drone, she'll know how to fly it. But all right, Elise, you ready?
Yeah.
Ready to go fly it? Did you download the app?
Oh, no.
1 hour later.
All right, so I just got inside from teaching Elise how to fly my drone. I think tomorrow, whenever they get out of school, I'm gonna show her how to use hers. But for now, I've gotta go to Starbucks because my group's meeting up. We're trying to finish like the last little thing we have to do for the class. So I'm gonna go do that and try and get home as soon as possible. Hi, gorgeous. How did you sleep? Oh my goodness. So she's finally awake. I saw her and Linda when we were flying the drone. I saw them through the drone and I was like, oh, they're at the door. I was wondering what they were doing. Cora is being so cute right now. She doesn't want to be set down. She just wants to be held by literally us two. And she just keeps like switching off. But we're going to give her a bath. Are you ready for bath time, baby?
You ready for bath?
Ready for it? She's like, no, because that means you have to set me down to get it ready. It's bath time, Cora. You're in the tub. Oh, wow. You seem to be enjoying this. Mm. She's like, I'm so pampered right now. This is great. Cora's just... She keeps turning this on every time I want to talk. But we've got a lot to do tonight. We've got a lot to do tomorrow. And I want to go ahead and get a head start on all of that. So we're going to go ahead and end our video for today. But we got our shout out before we do. And what is their name, Linda?
Our shout out for the...
Yes, Cora did it to you, not me.
Our shout out for today is Cheaper Ways NZ. Thank you so much for watching our video and for supporting us.
We're very grateful and we hope that everybody else will support us as well as you did. And our family will show you some love and support you as well. If you haven't liked our video, make sure you like our video.
Make sure you subscribe and hit the bell icon to receive notifications.
And we'll be seeing you tomorrow. Bye. Bye. Say bye, Cora.